Creating design rules within SolidWorks is also really handy to keep your models robust, reliable, and also parametric to design changes that may occur further downstream. So here we've got a very simple example here where there are a couple of holes that couldn't be created in the same sketch because they are on planes that are perpendicular to one another. At the moment, each of the holes have a diameter of 30 millimeters and a cut depth of 40 millimeters. However, they aren't linked together. So if I change one of them, of course, the other one won't update. And there could be a design rule that you always need to use the same hole type and therefore hole diameter. So how can we go about capturing this in SolidWorks? Well, the obvious way would be to use an equation so you can make the dimensions equal to one another. However, that's actually quite long-winded for the requirement that we actually need. The other disadvantage of the equation editor is the fact that one of the values is driven by the other. This technique I'm going to show you here, called linked values, actually allows either of the two holes to be the driving force so that you can change either one of them to affect the other. So let me show you how it's done. So first of all, you need to expose one of the dimensions that you'd like to link. In this case, I'll go with the diameter. I then need to right-click the dimension, and I have the option called link values. I must give this a name, so let's call this hole diameter. What you'll see is the diameter itself then has a chain link icon applied next to it, so you know that it's part of a link. Also, an equations folder will be created in the design tree with a new variable for that linked value available for you to link to any other subsequent dimension downstream. Now, that doesn't have to be another diameter. It could actually be linked to the length of a line or the radius of an arc. Any dimension at all could be linked to that particular variable. So now, double clicking to expose the dimension from the other hole, right click, link values, and rather than typing in the value, the hole diameter now appears in the drop down list, as would any other additional link values that you'd created. I can OK this, and now there is a link shared between the two of them. So quite simply, if I change the value to 25 on one of the holes and just do a rebuild, they both change. But as I said earlier, you can actually have the driving force as either of those two holes, as opposed to knowing which one is driving the other. So make use of link values to keep your models nice and aligned, adding this design intent in early on in your modelling.